I'm going to show you guys what ridge bearings are. So in this picture here, I have a bridge, and the bridge bearings themselves are here on top of the piers, but below the bridge deck. Bridge bearings are in place to allow for the thermal expansion of the bridge deck itself. So the bridge deck expands and contracts with temperature changes, while the piers are stationary, carrying only axial loads.
To give you some perspective, I've seen a bearing account for 7 centimeter displacement of the deck due to the temperature change from winter to summer. The bearings we are researching are called elastomeric bearings, aka rubber bearings, and have steel shims within them to increase their vertical stiffness. Bearings come in many different shapes and sizes due to different load requirements. I have a scaled bearing here from previous research that Dr. Becker has done. To give you an example, within this rubber area, there are 19 steel shims.
So for bearings, usually the damage occurs at the interface between the steel shims and the rubber. So for our research, we're replicating these layers by creating these test samples, as you can see here. To replicate an elastomeric bearing, the layers within it have to be bonded together. So this is accomplished using a special bonding agent that's applied to all the surfaces. So this is before applying the bonding agent, and this is after. The bonding agent is activated by baking it while under constant pressure. This is done using this setup.
The first method we are exploring for monitoring the damage within an elastomeric bearing is by using the electrical properties of the material and measuring capacitance.
Theoretically, if one of the interfaces of the elastomeric bearing were to become debonded, the capacitance measurement should change. This change would help us to predict the level of damage within a real elastomeric bearing.
These are the images created by the ultrasound machine. On the left, we have the first steel rubber interface of our test sample, and on the right, we have the second interface. White indicates air gaps, and black indicates bonding.